Well, here on The Balancing Act, we strive to inform you about the latest and leading information to keep you and your family as healthy as possible. There is a deadly condition that affects people of all ages and backgrounds. It is called heart disease, and it's a topic that we've discussed quite often here on the show. Did you know that the American Heart Association reports that more than 16 million Americans have either survived a heart attack or been diagnosed with heart disease? So how do we keep our hearts healthy and reduce our risk of heart disease? Well, our next guest is going to give us the 411. Please welcome back to the show nutritionist and author Dr. Janet Brill. She joins us as part of our My Health series. Janet, good morning. Always good to see you.
Always good to see you, Tanya.
You know, you wrote this book, and it has a lot of great information in it. Why? Why'd you write the book?
Well, for two reasons. First of all, I am a registered dietitian, and I specialize in cardiovascular disease prevention. And I found that cardiac patients actually are not following a healthy, nutritious diet that would help them to prevent
heart disease. Even cardiac patients?
Cardiac patients, either because the diet is too restrictive, or perhaps they have not had the opportunity to have dietetic counseling, or maybe they just don't understand. It's too complicated. So I wanted to write a book about really what the science is showing is the best diet for heart patients to follow.
And, you know, it's no secret that heart disease affects so many people, but this hits really close to home for you, doesn't it?
Yeah, as it does, and that's another reason why I wrote the book. All the men that I love in my life actually have either died of heart disease or have it now. My dad had died of his second heart attack actually many years ago. My father-in-law just had his second open heart surgery, and then 2 years ago my husband, who at 51, which is young, had a heart attack.
Oh my goodness, it was very scary.
And
I guess it's one of those things too where you say, okay, so hindsight is 2020.
Yeah, especially because
your background. So, having said that, what would you have suggested that your husband Sam do to try to prevent his first heart attack?
Well, the irony is that he actually was afraid because his grandfather died at 35 of a heart attack.
Gosh.
So he was afraid that he would follow in his dad's footsteps as well. So he went in for an angiogram, actually 6 years prior to his heart attack, and he came out with a clean bill of health. And the physician told me that my husband had no cardiovascular disease. So, you know, looking back, that threw me off, of course. And I guess I underestimated the power of three risk factors. One, of course, is family history. And two was low HDL, the good cholesterol. Mm. My husband had low HDL, but he didn't have other risk factors. And I think the most important one that I really didn't think about was the effect of stress and emotional duress. Mm. Because at that time, prior to my husband's heart attack, he was in real estate here in Florida, and so with the real estate market crashing and the stress was just overwhelming. Combine that with his dad being back in the hospital for open heart, and I think that that's really what caused it.
Oh boy, you know, and the thing about it is this book, as I said, has so much great information, but there are also, as you know, a lot of plans, a lot of books out there. What makes this book different?
Well, the other plans restrict all the good stuff, oil and avocado and nuts and yummy stuff like that. So Mediterranean, that's the way everyone should be eating. Olive oil, beautiful greens and deeply colored vegetables, fruits like figs.
Ah, those are figs.
Yes,
okay.
Beans, lentils, fish, flax seeds, walnuts, and of course whole grains. And then to top
the
coup
d'etat,
yes,
my dear.
Delicious dark chocolate.
Love it.
With a little bit of red wine with your meal, and you can enjoy the good things in life and have a healthy heart.
If you don't have heart disease, is this a good diet to follow to help prevent it?
All of us should be eating this way and exercising.
Okay.
Okay, because heart disease is the number one killer of men and women in this country. So all of us should be eating this way, should be taking care of our hearts. This is an enjoyable way to do it, trust me.
It is. You know, when I was looking at this,
chocolate,
I will do my little clothes before I indulge there, but I'll hold it just so that it's safe.
Okay. But you can have one glass a day, but you want to get the real dark with the Pinot Noir or the the Cabernet Sauvignon, because that has a lot of that resveratrol, which is, you've probably heard about
that. Yes, absolutely.
And so, and it's filled with antioxidants and what's called polyphenols. In fact, red, if you're going to grab that glass of Chardonnay, you may want to think twice, because the red wine has about 10 times the amount of antioxidants.
And that's what I'd heard. Very good information. Yes. Dr. Janet Brill, as always, thank you for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
Oh,
and enjoy that dark chocolate.
The dark chocolate and the red wine.
That's good nutrition
news. I am set, my dear.